Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how to configure Apache Sling logging writer configuration in AEM to rotate the logs. Log writer configuration can be used to set up the log file rotation characteristics for log writers used by the loggers. You will have multiple options to rotate the logs. One is by size or based on the date schedule. Also, you can specify the number of log files to be kept. So let us see that. Okay, in AEM you can go into OSI configuration console. So here you can see, you can configure the logger over here. This is the logger configuration, Apache Sling logging logger configuration. So another one is Apache Sling logging writer configuration. So this writer configuration will help you to configure the rotation properties. So let me add a new configuration. So here the log file. So this log file name and whatever the log file name configured here, it should be matching. So then this configuration will be applied for that specific logger. So if you are not having any specific configuration here, the default one will be applied. So now if I show these properties, so here this is the log file name, then number of log files to be kept. So it's 5. If you want to keep all the log files, you can make it 0. So it's disabled, this property will be disabled. Then another one is log file threshold. So here two properties can be set in the same one. One is by size. So you can specify the size in KB, MB or GB. You can replace this with the size. So either I can specify something 5 KB. So otherwise you can, this is one is the date, you can schedule the date. So what does that mean is this is every day you need to rotate. So we have some other properties here maybe. So this means rollover at the beginning of each month, every month it will roll over. So every month it will create new file. So otherwise you can, this configuration means rollover at the first day of each week. So it will, the file will get rotated. This is on every day, so this is the default configuration. So every day the file will be get rolled. Then the next one is a rollover at midnight every day, also the mid of the each day, so two times it will get rolled. Then second one is every hour you can roll it. So otherwise every minute you can roll it. So these are all the different options for the date schedule. Okay, let me go back now. Yeah, so the buffered logging, if you want, you can enable it. What it will do is, right now it is a live, whatever the logging, it will immediately return into the log file, that is a behavior. So if you enable this, so it will be buffered. But here is a challenge, is if the application server is crashed in the middle or some other issue, you will be losing your logs. Okay, yeah, let's now see, one of the option in AEM, you can configure this through this OSI console, but it is not recommended. The recommendation is to configure this through the OSI config, so that you can enable, specify which run mode that configuration should be applied. So let's go and create a configuration. For that, I'm just copying this. This is my factory configuration. Okay, I will go here. So I am going to this config, this vretail under config. So I am going and creating a new node. Yeah, because this is a prop, this is a the factory configuration, just enter some string, Unix string. So I am going with the error log, so error. Okay, now this is fine. Now what you need to do is you need to add all the properties. So go here, the first property is the log file name. You can just copy this. That's a string anyhow. So just you can enter this. Yep. So this is fine now. Next one is the number of log file. This property you can copy there. Yep. So the default is 5. So maybe you can change it accordingly. So that many files will be kept in the system. Remaining files will be deleted. So this is fine. Another property is this one. So size. Yep. Okay, creative size, I am going with maybe for now, like for testing 5 KB I will go, but you can configure whatever you want. That's fine. Then yeah, this is fine. I'm ignoring it. That's a default value. Okay, that's fine. I'm going to save this. Yep, that's fine. Now yeah, let us now test it. Yeah, you can see the configuration is reflected here with the, all these values whatever we scheduled. Now what we do is let me go and clear the logs whatever is already there. So I have some error log one. Now let's access some pages so that some log file will get created. So still it's not, maybe we can access multiple times. Yeah, now if you see here, like the log files are like rotated, it's like when the size crosses, yeah, so it's getting created, the rotated. Now another option is like you can go here, maybe you can change this to like every minute or hour or like a month or based on the requirement. So maybe demo purpose I will go with every minute. Okay, I will just change this, the same property. Yes, I will save this. Now let me delete this whatever got created initially. Okay, fine. Now let me again access some of the now if you see like it's created a new file so with the timestamp so every minute the new file will be created. Log message should be written so otherwise it will not be creating new file. Whenever there is some log written and every 1 minute so the new file will be created. Okay, thanks all for watching the video. So see you in the next video.